Now we can create a database in Virtual Data Port. To create a new database in Virtual Data Port administration tool, first we have to log in using an administrator user. By default, the user admin is created and has all the privileges to perform this action. It is a best practice to change the default password of this user or create new administrator users. For now, let's use the default admin user and let's click on the administration menu and click the database management option. A new panel is opened where we can see the list of created databases. To add a new database, click on the new button. In this dialog, a new database can be created and the following information has to be provided. Let's see the available parameters in detail. Name of the database. For example, let's type Denodo Training New. Description of the database, which is an optional parameter. Identifiers car set. There are three options. If you select default, the database will use the setting configured for the entire server. Restricted. With this configuration, you can only use basic characters in the names of elements and fields, which are case insensitive. Unicode. In this mode, you can use any character in the names of the data sources, views, columns, etc. This also means that the elements will be case sensitive. The next three options are related to the configuration of the Denodo optimizer. The first parameter is the automatic cost-based optimization. Enabling this option will make the execution engine select the best execution plan based on the estimated cost of executing them. To estimate the cost of an execution plan, the execution engine uses the indexes of the queried tables in the database and the statistics of the views. There are three options: default, for using the value configured in the server; off, to disable this option for this database; and on, to enable it in this particular database. The second parameter is the automatic simplification of queries. Enabling this option will make the execution engine simplify the queries before the actual query execution takes place. We will have the same options to use the default value or to disable or enable the static optimization techniques in this database. And the last optimization parameter is the summary rewrite optimization. This is a new option in Denodo 8 to use smart query acceleration techniques with a new type of view called a summary. Again, we have the options to disable or enable it in this database. Next is the authentication type. There are two options available for user authentication. The first one is the internal user authentication. Using this authentication method, when a user tries to connect to this database, Virtual Data Port will check the credentials of this user with the list of users created in Virtual Data Port. These users are the ones created in the user management dialog of the administration tool. For example, the default admin user is an internal user. The next one is LDAP authentication. Use this option to delegate the authentication of users to an LDAP server. As you can see by clicking on this option, you have to fill the connection information to your LDAP server. This greatly simplifies the management of users, as all of them are created in the LDAP server, for example, in a Windows domain. At runtime, when a user tries to connect to this database, Denodo will connect to the LDAP server to check the user credentials. If the credentials are correct, the server will obtain the roles assigned to this user to know if they are authorized to connect. Finally, there is an option to enable Kerberos authentication for ODBC and ADO.NET clients in case you have enabled Kerberos in Virtual Data Port. Once you have configured all the parameters, you can click OK and the new database will be created.